Hello folks, MinMax Munchkin back with a long-awaited update video for the Barbarian, whatever you wanna call it really. A character designed to take as much damage as possible and still be standing, laughing or, well, roaring in enemies' faces. The fundamental principles are still the same, but there are a few differences resulting from the racial changes in the Eberron Rising from the Last War book, as well as my own experience playing this character several times since I made the first video about it. Kalashtar is still the only real racial choice for this character because it is the only race that offers resistance to psychic damage via its mental discipline trait, something that this type of character otherwise wouldn't have. You can use any other race, but psychic damage will then be your weak spot. Dual mind trait has been buffed as well, no longer requiring your reaction to gain advantage on any type of wisdom saving throw, arguably the most important mental save in the game. However, official Kalashtar race no longer has a flexible third ability score bonus. Instead, you have a fixed +2 wisdom bonus and a +1 charisma as before, which means you're not starting with 16 strength at level 1, but you can shuffle the points around and get a slightly higher dexterity score for a higher armor class. Odd scores in constitution and charisma allow you to either pick one extra feat or simply even them out at some point during your progression. Ability scores aren't as mechanically meaningful for this character as are the select few class features that push its effective hit points into the ridiculous territory. Kalashtars might be resistant to psychic damage, but Totem Barbarian's Rage combined with its Bear Totem Spirit allows you to resist all other damage types. In other words, when you're raging, you're taking only half damage no matter what. Next, Moon Druid's Combat Wild Shape and Circle Forms features elegantly fit the action economy and give you a sizable buffer of extra hit points that replenish after a short rest. You can even spend your druid's spell slots and heal yourself in the middle of the fight. At some point, you will have more hit points than this video will have likes, but as long as you keep the like-dislike bar's hit points above zero, it will keep fighting. You also have to make sure you wild shape the subscribe button and give the bell notification icon a sentinel feat so that the big bad YouTube algorithm final boss can never disengage and steal away this channel's videos from you. So be a proper support character and cast some cure wounds on these smashed and beat down buttons below. Everybody needs more hit points, thank you very much. In all seriousness, I think sentinel feat is a must on this character. All the hit points this character has won't matter much if the DM decides to ignore you and focus fire on the squishier party members. You have to make yourself a target worth paying attention to, and this feat will give you that extra edge to incentivize the monsters into attacking you back instead of one-shotting that 15 hit point wizard behind you. Besides these most important features and traits, the happy marriage between a Bear Totem Barbarian and a Moon Druid offers a few other synergies as well. With a few exceptions, Druid's core wild shape feature allows you to benefit from all other class features, racial traits, feats, and spells when you are transformed into a beast. Your Barbarian's Reckless Attack will increase your accuracy when transformed. Unarmored Defense will increase some of your beast form's armor class, but only by +1, maybe +2. Don't forget about Danger Sense either. Why fail on dexterity saving throws against fireball and take half damage when you can succeed and take just a quarter of it, right? Tough Feat will make you much tankier in your humanoid form, though that feat specifically doesn't carry over into a beast form, because your hit points get replaced by the hit points of a beast. At higher levels, your elemental wild shape forms gain all of these benefits too, making those challenge rating 5 elementals stronger than they normally are. Last but not least, if you decide to play a more martially oriented character, Barbarian's level 5 extra attack feature is also interesting because beast forms without multi-attack usually have higher hit points, armor class, and deal more damage per hit. Well, with 2 attacks, your damage matches or in some cases even exceeds that of beast forms that do have multi-attack, so do keep that in mind. Now, everybody knows that you cannot cast or concentrate on spells while raging. Still, you won't be fighting all the time, so here's a list of spells that I'd consider preparing for this character. I won't go through all of them, otherwise this would be a 25-minute video, but let me point out Long Strider's 1-hour benefit, which you can pre-cast before and it extends into your beast forms, systems, allowing you to reach distant enemies faster and easier. Freedom of movement is an obvious candidate for precasting as well, helping you against grapples, restraints, and even paralysis, while simultaneously making it easier to move across a difficult terrain. Finally, if you ever go to level 20, besides the obvious case for dropping barbarian levels altogether for that insane art druid level 20 feature, shape change spell will allow you to become a challenge rating 20 monster instead of some pesky challenge rating 5 beast or a challenge rating 5 elemental. Still, wild shaping into various beasts is what you will be doing for the majority of your adventuring career. There are a lot of good options, but a few do stand out in my opinion. Challenge rating 1 has a lot of good choices. Brown Bear is the best overall pick with decent hit points, armor class, a decent damage multi-attack option, and an obvious thematic fit for the Bear Totem Barbarian subclass. Notable alternatives are Giant Spider, which can restrain enemies, Giant Hyena and Giant Octopus with a crap ton of hit points, a Tiger for night combat, and maybe a Direwolf with its pack tactics trait. In the challenge rating 2 category, Giant Constrictor Snake dominates with its super high hit point pool and an auto restraining attack. Cave or Polar Bear is close behind as a solid upgrade compared to Brown Bear. Giant Boar's Relentless trait is interesting for its interaction with your Bear Totem Rage, effectively requiring at least 22 damage in one go to knock you back down to your humanoid form. Challenge rating 3 is dominated by a Giant Scorpion, whose multi-attack comes with not 2, but 3 attacks that grapple their targets. Giant Snapping Turtle is an absolute tank with 17 armor class and 75 hit points. Bristled Moorbounder has a very fast movement speed, but if your DM only allows basic beasts from Monster's Manual, Ankylosaurus will do the trick with high hit points and armor class. Giant Subterranean Lizard is probably the best challenge rating for beast with its auto restrain attack, but Giant Coral Snake can even be better with the potential to stun, incapacitate, or even paralyze its targets. If none of these special beasts are on the table, become an elephant and just stomp around. Challenge rating 5 is where Giant Crocodile resides, with the only downside to its auto restraint attack being that you often won't be able to focus the same enemy with both of your attacks. That's why you can also become a hulking crab, and if you want the most hit points you can possibly have, Brontosaurus is as good as it gets. Spells are nice, beast forms are cool, but what about items? Well, it gets tricky with Moon Druids, or pretty much any other druid out there, because those beast forms are often not capable of using these magic items and therefore have to either drop them or merge them into their form, but still, there are some solid options. Amulet of Health makes sense for when you're in a humanoid form. Flat 19 constitution score given by this item allows you to have high hit points and at the same time dedicate one or even two ability score improvements towards wisdom, improving your druid's spellcasting capabilities. Insignia of Claws buffs your beast forms with a +1 magical bonus to their natural weapons attacks and damage rolls. Ring of Protection is a solid option on any character, and I don't see the reason why you wouldn't be able to fit this onto a claw or a paw, same as you fit it onto your hand. Sentinel Shield is solid primarily for its initiative advantage, allowing you to enter rage before you take any damage, but Animated Shield sounds super fun as well on a raging beast, even though it further loads the already bottlenecked bonus action. Of course, you may or may not get these items, but you will always have all of your hundreds of hit points, so let's do some min-max mathematics now and see how many of them can this character actually have. An important thing to have in mind is that whenever you're raging and take only half damage, you round it down if it's an odd number. For example, 7 damage becomes 3 damage, 11 damage is 5, 17 is 8, you get the point. That's why you usually have more than double your maximum effective hit points while raging. So, a level 5 character, for example, with 2 Moon Druid and 3 Bear Totem Barbarian levels, can wild shape into a Brown Bear for that juicy multi-attack and all the flavor and theme you can wish for. It's 34 hit points, double up to 68, effectively 70. You have 2 wild shape uses per short rest, so that 70 is basically nearly doubled up to 140. Your base humanoid form with 15 constitution has 44 hit points, doubled up to 88, effectively 90. On top of that, you can use your 3 level 1 druid spell slots to heal yourself, which is another 27 hit points on average, potentially even 30. Add these 3 numbers together, you're looking at around 250 effective hit points at level 5. Assuming you get at least one short rest and both of your wild shapes back, you can repeat this entire process again for more than 400 effective hit points during an adventuring day. At level 15, if you go for a more martially oriented character and turn yourself into an air elemental, which has the lowest hit points by the way, following this same logic, you can have almost 900 effective hit points. Maybe even above 1000 if you count in the short rest. Now, I won't bother with level 20, because as I said already, you're better off with just a single class Moon Druid with its infinite uses of wild shape, but you do get well above 1500 effective hit points even with this character. I can imagine a scenario where you would need more than that at level 20, but it's a very, very extreme one, to say the least. As you can see it on the screen, you can make this character have a more martially oriented or a more spellcasting oriented approach. You can always choose to deviate from my suggestions and recommendations. In fact, that's what I would probably even advise. Things happen, stuff changes, and speaking about changes, I made one big change to this character. Your starting level is in Druid, not Barbarian. Yes, this will reduce your maximum hit points by a few points. However, after playing it multiple times so far, I'm convinced the most optimal approach for this character is to have proficiency in intelligence and wisdom saving throws instead of strength and constitution. This is a much better long-term investment. Barbarians often struggle with these mental saves, namely wisdom. There's a reason why the prevailing opinion on how to deal with the bear totem barbarian, or any barbarian for that matter, is to simply charm, dominate, or possess it in some way and then send it against the party. Well, starting in Druid will stack the odds against that scenario in your favor. There's no guarantee, of course, natural ones happen all the time, but with Kalashtar's dual mind, proficiency in wisdom saves, and a relatively high wisdom score, you will be better off than 99% of barbarians out there. All these mechanics can and probably should indirectly tie to the way you roleplay this character. The calmer mental state of a Kalashtar race mixed with the furious primal barbarism and wild bestial druidic magic. It's no secret I most enjoy playing characters with opposing dualities to their personality, behavior, and disposition. This one fits that trope very, very well. You can always choose to be more one-sided, however, I find it a little difficult to justify such a character with all of these colorful tendencies, right? In terms of alignment, the only hard stance that I have for this character is its chaotic bent. I almost cannot imagine anything else. However, it can be totally evil, it can be neutral, it can be good, depending on what kind of path you want to explore in relation to its spiritual guide and a propensity to take ridiculous amounts of abuse and still somehow be standing, stoically enduring through all of that pain. You can even go a step further and tie the common theme of a Kalashtar quarry spirits with the flavor of a barbarian's bear totem spirit, some kind of unique amalgamation of a more abstract alien spirit and a more familiar animalistic concept bound together in a singular entity that provides you with not just elevated physical and mental capabilities, but a deep well of natural magic that allows you to channel all these powers to maintain composure and consciousness even in most dire of situations. As you can see me scrolling through it on the screen, I updated the old Word file with new information, went a bit more into detail about some of these things, and did my best to clarify potentially confusing or contradicting information. I mean, this thing has almost 5,500 words. So, if you would like to download it, head on over to my Patreon page and pledge into the Magical Secrets tier. You will also get access to my private Discord channel, where you can ask questions, argue about mechanics all day and night, or just post juicy D&D memes. This is not mandatory, this is 100% optional, especially in these troubled, globally challenging economic times, but if you do find the Patreon perks worth your trouble, worth your time, time and worth your money, consider supporting my efforts there. Special shout out to all of my current patrons: Mike, Matthew, Ewing, Barleyman, Harley, Trying, Grogor, Caleron, Suburban Hell, Gary Kors, Brad Olhan, Jolie Salcazar, Sean Manozzi, Stefano, Clyde Aquia, Devin Yek, Alex Bell, Harry Howell, Crack Mask, Alexandra Day, Nicholas Joseph, Francisco Martinez, Kila Nudella 18, Russ Helms, Primal Bass Boost, Ted Reichardt, Steven Keezer, Derek Peck, Barbon, Bernie's Posting, Devon Troger, Sean Walker, James Arendt, Wesley Schick, Edge Walker, Jacob Nether, Robin Smith, Kyler Beverly, Jacob Salters, Paul Gibbs, Wicked Redstone, Thomas Gardner, Charby, Burley Bjorn, Christopher Pistachio, Superney, Lebby Coats, Neko, Devin Adam Howard, Nathaniel Besansini, Creepy Chunky Guy, Jesse Bruffet, Tooth and Nail Rules, Jacob Metzger, Sterling Garza, Jamie Harris, Todd John Gamma, Alec Greenwood, Meher Cute, Georgios Kritsotakis, Harley Long, Edric, Iroquin, Alex Duran, Elvis Yang, Clay Puma, Maximus S, Anthony Verdoni, Tuxedo, Black and Shadows, John Bush, Ryan Heavier, Ray Brooks, Philippe Charbonneau, Benny Jude, Dynamite Studios, Justin Blakenship, Random Pleb, Horse the Seller, Malavtras, The Shad, Hector, Monterey Brandwolf, Spencer LeBute, William Rogers, Olin Clark, Kalugaru, Devon Witzer, Riven, Tint White, Corey Closen, Kazoko, Tim Turboville, Anthony Gunter, Kevin Martel, Mad Mike, Sean Jarrett, Joshua Ferreira, Kelly Bolduc, William Yuri, Daniel Bemish, Vanessa B. Alvarez, Paul Herzig, Jack Monson. Thank you for your continued support. I'll make sure you get many more videos like this one in the following days, weeks, and months. With everything said and done, me and Max Munchkin out. Talk to you soon.